Hari Om friends, welcome once again to my Sanatan Duniya channel, your spiritual home. In this video, I shall be giving my commentary upon verses 29 to 35 of the 18th chapter of the Bhagavad Gita. For those of you who have not yet watched the commentaries on the previous verses of the Gita, I suggest you go ahead and watch these videos before proceeding further with this video. These videos are available in the playlist titled Bhagavad Gita Commentary, all 18 chapters. Before I go ahead and give the commentary upon these verses of the 18th chapter of the Bhagavad Gita, I have a small request to make. If you have not already subscribed to my channel, then I suggest you do so that you may be updated about forthcoming videos uploaded to this channel. So let's move on. The 29 to 32nd slokas of the 18th chapter of the Gita are as follows. Now, O winner of wealth, please listen as I tell you in detail of the three kinds of understanding and determination according to the three modes of nature. O son of Pritha, that understanding by which one knows what ought to be done and what ought not to be done, what is to be feared and what is not to be feared, what is binding and what is liberating, that understanding is established in the mode of goodness. And that understanding which cannot distinguish between the religious way of life and the irreligious, between action that should be done and action that should not be done, that imperfect understanding, O son of Pritha, is in the mode of passion. That understanding which considers irreligion to be religion and religion to be irreligion under the spell of illusion and darkness and strives always in the wrong direction, O Partha, is in the mode of ignorance. The commentary of the mentioned four slokas is as follows. After Bhagwan spoke about the three kinds of action, agents and knowledge, now Bhagwan educates Arjuna about the three kinds of understanding also according to the three gunas of Prakriti. When one is in knowledge or even when one is under the mode of Sattva Guna, one tends to have the right understanding about Dharma and all spiritual matters. And it is found that such people with their right understanding are able to guide others on the spiritual path too. These people who are under the mode of Sattva Guna know fully well what is to be done and what is not to be done. They understand that to do one's duty in accordance with Dharma is to be done and all immoral, unethical and illegal activities are to be shunned. Such people, since they are under the mode of goodness, follow the instructions and injunctions of the scriptures. They take the scriptures as authority for deciding what should be done and what should not be done. These are the type of people who live according to the values and principles of life and also according to the instructions of God and Guru. They understand that to do one's duty is not to be feared and to commit sins and pursue immoral habits and activities are to be feared. Not only this, since they are spiritually inclined, they understand that attachment, lust, greed, etc. are binding for their soul and that spiritual knowledge, wisdom, devotion and service are liberating for their soul. Hence, they do only those actions which are favorable for liberation and avoid actions which promote bondage. On the other hand, those who cannot distinguish between religion and irreligion and between what should be done and what should not be done are having understanding in the mode of passion. Following such an understanding, they indulge in activities and pleasures which are binding for the soul. Hence, such souls, after their life on earth, quickly return to the earth and reincarnate, and they do not attain the goal of life, namely liberation. These people tend to be materialistic and ostentatious. Because of their faulty understanding regarding Dharma, they don't realize the fact that their attachments and passions are leading them towards bondage. They rarely perform activities conducive for spiritual growth and realization. Lastly, Bhagwan talks about understanding in the mode of ignorance. These people who have such tamasic understanding mix up religion and irreligion. They consider sin to be desirable and merit or piety to be undesirable. This is due to the influence of tamogun in their minds. They always strive in the wrong direction and want to prosper through illegal and unlawful activities and pursuits. Due to their lack of spiritual and moral education, they are under the spell of darkness, because of which they cannot even recognize what is wrong with their activities. These people set a wrong example for others. Now I shall move on to verses 33 to 35. The 33rd to 35th verses of the 18th chapter of the Gita are as follows. O son of Pritha, that determination which is unbreakable, which is sustained with steadfastness by yoga practice, and thus controls the mind, life and the acts of the senses, is in the mode of goodness. And that determination by which one holds fast to fruitive result in religion, economic development and sense gratification, is of the nature of passion, O Arjuna. And that determination which cannot go beyond dreaming, fearfulness, lamentation, moroseness and illusion, such unintelligent determination is in the mode of darkness. The commentary of the mentioned three slokas is as follows. Here in these three slokas, Bhagavan is enlightening Arjuna about the three kinds of determination in accordance with the three modes of material nature. Firstly, regarding determination in the mode of goodness. People who possess such determination tend to be strong and unbreakable in their determinations and resolves. Nothing can shake such people. No matter whether they encounter good times or hard times, their morale and enthusiasm remains intact. People who possess such determination in the mode of goodness owe this quality of theirs to the yoga practice in which they engage wholeheartedly. Because of their steady practice of yoga and belief in themselves and God, they have complete control over their senses, mind and intelligence. Due to this, they remain unshaken and resolute under all circumstances. Next, Bhagavan talks about determination in the mode of passion. When one possesses such determination, one tends to be attached to the fruits of their activities and hence they are bound. Whether it be religion, economic development or even sense gratification, they are very eager to enjoy the fruits of all their activities and are highly passionate. People who possess such determination in the mode of passion tend to be highly materialistic and easily swayed by success and failure. And since they are attached to the fruits of their actions, they are filled with anxieties due to uncertainties. Lastly, Bhagwan talks about determination in the mode of ignorance. This type of determination causes dreaming, illusion and hallucination. There is no steadiness in such determination. Such people often tend to lament and be morose due to unfavorable circumstances. They cannot find the resolute will to withstand difficulties. Rather, in the face of difficulties, people with such understanding become morose and lose all enthusiasm and courage. These are the people who require guidance from those who possess determination in the mode of goodness. Hence, as spiritual seekers, it is important that we develop an understanding and determination in the mode of goodness. Such an understanding and determination shall guide us further on the spiritual path and lead us gradually to the ultimate goal of life, namely liberation. So friends, here ends the commentary on the 29th to 35th verses of the 18th chapter of the Bhagavad Gita. Stay tuned for more commentaries on the following verses of the Gita and keep checking this channel for updates to this playlist titled Bhagavad Gita Commentary All 18 Chapters, and also do watch the other videos available in this channel so that you can enhance your knowledge of the eternal religion or Sanatan Dharma. And in case you have not already subscribed to my channel, then I suggest you do so that you may be updated about forthcoming videos uploaded to this channel. Thank you very much for watching. Have a great time ahead. Hari Om.